All right, excited to be here and to tell you about the future of computing and AI infrastructure. First time at Web Summit, looks like an incredible conference. And let's get going. We only got 18 minutes. Let's see if we'll just jump in here. All right, maybe. I'm just seeing Web Summit slides. Okay, still just seeing Web Summit slides. Maybe. Here we go. All right, we're getting started for real. I'm Nick, co-founder, CEO of Lightmatter. We are building the future of computing, and the future of computing is going to be all about linking together lots of GPUs and custom chips that are focused on AI and linking them efficiently and very fast. So let's go through that story and talk about what this future is going to look like. It's been an incredible decade of breakthroughs in artificial intelligence, from the AlexNet result in around 2012 to the publication of AI models achieving human-level control in video games, to AlphaGo beating Lee Sedol at the game of Go, a game that's computationally intractable. It's something that you can't brute force actually calculate all the different paths, unlike chess. It's a challenge that people viewed as a bit of a grand challenge in computing. And then, as we're all aware, GPT-3 coming out, really the big bang in the generative AI movement. It's just been a breakthrough time period for AI computing, and it's all been powered by enormous progress in how many calculations per second these chips can do, and the scale of the number of chips that we're using. So on that note, we can take a look at what's been required to enable this AI boom. There's been about a 2.1 billion x improvement in the number of operations per second that AI chips can perform. These operations are typically multiplies and adds, and they lie at the heart of deep learning and artificial intelligence. So from AlexNet 10 to the 16 to the frontier AI models of 2025, 2.1 billion X. I mean, that's a sort of improvement that you can't imagine in any field other than computing. And it's been the result of enormous investment and innovation at how chips are architected, how we do memory, and all these different pieces. But this is what underlies the progress engine that you're seeing in artificial intelligence. So at the very base of this technology stack, you have the transistor. And the growth in computing, the number of operations per second that we can do, is enabled by improvements in the number of transistors you can fit in a computer chip. The more transistors you have, the more math you can do, the bigger the AI models, and the more advanced the AI models get. And we've had, since the 1960s, a doubling of these computational elements, the transistor per chip, every 18 months. And that doubling looks something like this, from 1 to 2 to 4 to 8 to 16 to 32, all the way to where we're at today, which is 100 trillion transistors per chip. But the bad news is that this scaling law has ended. So we've hit a wall. And the only way to scale at this point is by linking together these final node chips with a trillion transistors, linking those together in large arrays. So the future isn't about performance per computer chip getting better. It's about linking together lots of chips. And here you can see the links shown in red, and really the same chip just being tiled out. It's pretty wild. You think about growing up, you buy a computer, 5 years later, that computer is incredibly slow. Your experience today is not like that at all. You probably have a MacBook that's 5 years old, and it's still running just fine. And that's all underlined by the challenge that we're at right now. So the only way to gain performance is to have more chips and to link them together with incredibly fast, low-power interconnects. And here's the data that kind of underlies that. So here we're showing Intel and NVIDIA and the size of their computer chips as a function of time. So the only way that we're getting performance for AI-based compute and compute in general going forward is bigger chips and more of them. You can see that evidenced here by the exponential plot for the amount of silicon, which is what we build computer chips out of, in a single package. So you've probably heard about XAI and their 100,000 GPU clusters, 200,000 coming online soon. Well, there's going to be 1 million GPU clusters that are coming online over the next several years. The data centers that are being built use as much power as cities like New York City. New York is about 7.5 gigawatts, and these new data centers are about 7 gigawatts. So you think about the scale of these systems. And what's really challenging is the way they're built today, they're not really acting like a single computer. But this is the train of progress, and it's an incredible rate of change here. So on that power story, we can kind of visualize it. If you look at Los Angeles, you're at 2.5 gigawatts. If you look at New York City, 7.5 gigawatts. Meta is building a cluster that's 2 gigawatts. Stargate from OpenAI is about 5 gigawatts. So the scale is quite wild here. Just a little image for you to think about what this means. These data centers, the power density is such that if you were to look at planet Earth through a thermal imager, so you're looking at the planet, what are the bright things that you'll see? You'll see volcanoes, you'll see sunlit deserts, and these data centers, these new data centers that we're building, are going to be right up there with the brightest objects on the planet. You're using as much power as New York City in an area that's only a few square miles. So it's a pretty wild future that we're headed into. So what do these data centers look like? Well, this is a typical picture. You've got a row of compute and networking chips. So let's take a look at how these are connected today and then talk about what the future looks like. So today, you can link together a couple of computer racks in a high bandwidth domain using copper wires. They can only reach about this far, and so you need to pack these racks very close to each other. And the AI models are really executing inside of that pair of racks, and then pairs of racks are synchronizing. But there isn't a single computation that's happening across the entire row of the data center. It's really these little mini brains that are laced together with very low speed interconnect. So if you're an AI architect, you're looking at these systems, and it's really not what you'd like to have. You'd really like this entire system to be one giant computer, and it's not today. One giant brain, today it's a bunch of mini brains. OK, so we've zoomed into interconnect here. It's the future of computing. How do you link together all these chips? Well, here's the rate of progress. So if we look over the past couple decades, compute has gotten about 10 million times better over the past couple decades. Interconnect, maybe 1,000x. And as you play time forward, the gap between the progress in interconnect, how these chips communicate, and how fast they are is going to continue to grow. And this is a major bottleneck for the progress of AI. So the question that we ask ourselves at Lightmatter is, what does it take to build a single brain, million XPU data center? But the challenges that you have to solve, copper is only able to lace maybe 100 chips together. And we need about 100 times more bandwidth. Today, people are at 1 terabit per second of I/O. You need to get to 100 terabit per second. And to do this, you're going to need fundamentally new technology. What if we could make light the foundation of computer chips going forward? And I mean that literally. What if light could be the foundation of future computer chips? So this is our technology passage. And what we do is we take GPUs and switches that are used to build these AI supercomputers, and we 3D stack them on top of our substrate passage. And now those chips can communicate using optical fiber to the outside world and link up the entire data center as one supercomputer. 100 terabit per second in a single chip. Just for reference, you know what that number really means. When you connect continents together with optical fiber, the bandwidth is about 200 terabit per second. So two of Lightmatter's chips matches the bandwidth of the cables that connect the internet across the continents. It's quite a significant amount of bandwidth. We can zoom into this a little bit and try to understand what's going on. What we do is we leverage standard technologies for assembling computer chips. This is known as chip-on-wafer assembly. This is how all GPUs are built today. You get a wafer, and you stack your chips on top of the wafer. And when you're done, you cut that section out, and you've got a completed GPU or a switch or whatever it is you're building. This is actually what a cross-section of the chip looks like. The bottom black starry night is our chip passage, and the top black starry night in the stack there is our partnerships. We partner with companies, silicon companies, and also hyperscale data centers that build their own computer chips. So we've got 256 optical fibers on the platform. That means that a single one of these chips can link together 256 other GPUs directly with no switches or anything else. And that's an unprecedented amount of interconnection that we have on this technology. 34 chips that are sitting on top. So this is a very large computer chip. It's about this big. We talked about the fact that the future of computing is really about getting to large chips and then linking many arrays of these large chips together. And here's what they actually look like. So this is our platform M1000. We launched this earlier this year at our Lightmatter Interconnect event. And again, this is about the bandwidth of an undersea cable that connects the US to France. So an incredible amount of bandwidth. In the image, you can actually see the optical fibers. You can see the chip, the M1000 there, and the PCB that it all sits on. So what does the data center look like? We've fundamentally changed how the chips are packaged, how big they could be, and how they interconnect together. This is looking at one of the servers, one of these M1000 servers, and imagining what the data center is going to look like as you deploy this kind of technology at scale. We showed the image earlier of a row of racks, and they only had pairs of racks that were connected in orange. And there was very weak interconnect between the pairs of racks, a bunch of mini brains. Well, this is what a million XPU, a million GPU data center looks like with Lightmatter passage technology. So we'll let this play, and you can see how these data centers are going to look. So you've got the optical fibers that are coming out of the back of the rack, and these can go hundreds of meters to kilometers. And they're used to interconnect all of the compute elements, all of the GPUs that are running your AI training job or your AI inference job. If you guys have used deep research or you've tried any of these reasoning models, you've seen that some of the queries can take 10, 12 minutes to run. What if you had a giant cluster that was executing that workload? And what if you got the answer back in half a second? That's kind of what we're talking about. We're also talking about a future where frontier models aren't being released every 6 months. They're being released every 2 months, maybe 1.5 months. Imagine if Anthropic, OpenAI, Google, and everyone else had that kind of innovation cadence. I know everyone's excited about generative AI and all of the software development implications for that. This will drive that whole roadmap, with incredible speed. And I just want to take you back a little bit here to think about the bigger picture of what's happening. So we talked about the fundamentals of computing. Transistors are no longer improving. We're not getting more transistors per chip. And the way that humanity makes computers faster today is by taking chips and linking them together in arrays. As of this moment, we're building data centers that use as much power as the biggest cities in the world, New York City. If you play this forward 50, maybe 100 years, it might be the case that Mars is the data center of the future. Maybe this is the HAL 9000 that's running the AI models that'll come out in 50 years. So this is what the future of computing looks like, and I'm happy to share this with you guys, and thank you.